recording the album in January of this year in California. Martin and Dave had been writing songs previously, previous few months for the album.
I really felt like when we started this album, or way before that, that there was definitely unfinished business. We've made some really, really good albums together, but you know, it's still that feeling of like, still want to make the best record that we possibly can, and still striving for that. There's something that you haven't yet completed, you know, or something for some reason.
We started in the first 5 weeks on about 11 songs.
Which is a world record for Depeche Mode.
I think it was after about the fifth song or so that we, you know, realised that there was some kind of a direction.
We spent a lot of time trying to pick a producer, decided on Ben Hillier. It wasn't really the music he'd done before. It was more his attitude.
You know, he works pretty fast, and you know, there was a constant sort of energy flowing in the studio. You know, a lot more than actually the last couple of records that we made. I think he kind of had an idea of where he wanted to go pretty quickly.
The last couple of albums they made, Ultra and Exciter, took quite a long time to make, and I don't think that they benefit from that, really. What I felt was they would benefit from working more quickly. Mm-hmm. I just feel we got a lot more energy into the record because of that, mm-hmm. and a lot more creativity.
But I wanted to make something that was had a much broader palette than the last record, and that was kind of a bit dirtier and crunchier and nastier sounding.
He uses a lot of instrumentation, like analog stuff, old analog synths.
I think references old Depeche Mode stuff more, which is surprising, as Ben is definitely not a big fan of Depeche Mode. Not that he's not a fan, but he didn't know a lot about us, put it that way.
Which was also quite nice to us, because he had no sort of conceptions of what he had to do. You know, he was really, these are the songs, let's get a sound going. And there wasn't any sort of past record that he had to think of.
Mark went into the other room and started playing around with this idea, and we could hear him sort of developing it a bit. And so that was kind of exciting in the first place. We weren't sure where it was going, but when we started the next session, we got into it. We've started out with some heavy drums. Like Ben gets on the drums, and starts Benny Bonham, we call him.
That sort of thing is the verse groove, you know, so it's sort of like a real...
Ben kind of likes to work like that, you know. I just get on like a sort of live mic in the studio, and that was fun. And then usually you sort of kind of start looking at it and tearing it apart.
Depeche Mode are strange compared to other bands in that they turn up the recording studio with very complete ideas, song-wise. What we'll do then is sort of deconstruct that track and rebuild it in a way that to help shape the sound of the record. Because obviously when they're writing the tracks and writing the demos, they're not that worried about getting necessarily the right sounds or the sounds fitting in with other tracks. You're just working on the inspiration of the songs.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1
hard work. He's got lungs of steel.
Mary had a little lamb whose fleece was white as snow, and everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go.
I think it's always, for me, you know, a bit a scary prospect, thinking about a whole album. The thought of having to write 9 songs or whatever, 9, 10 songs, is always, a bit scary.
I think Mark was just as nervous as me, you know, to be honest, about playing these songs. So it's really quite a painful experience.
I've never seen our music as being over dark. I think that there is always an element of hope in our music, and I've always said that that comes through in the overall feeling of the music. One of the surprising things about this record is the tempo. It's a lot faster than the last two records that we've made, maybe even the last three, but definitely the last two. The tempo's gone up maybe because I've been DJing more, so I've been buying a lot more dance music. And you know, it's not, I didn't go out of my way to start writing songs in a faster, but you know, I think that it does come out subconsciously. There's always, you know, whatever you're listening to probably comes out.
I'll never be free. I'll never be let you rest. Sisters and brothers will never recover from this tenderness.
I think it's an interesting record. My feelings towards how it sounds in the end is very positive. I think it's extremely strong record. I think it shows that the band are still a very potent force in terms of songwriting and ideas and performing. It's a very contemporary sounding record and great songs.